In the ring at this time, to my right, from Miami, Florida, weighing 245 pounds, Jim Young. And his opponent, led towards the ring by his manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan. From Tampa, Florida, weighing 252 pounds, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
Well, a self-professed Mr. Wonderful, we might add. Paul Orndorff, one of the premier athletes. You hear the chant already beginning. The Paula chant. And Mr. Orndorff does not like what he hears whatsoever. Yes, Bobby the Brain is out there. Look at that gorgeous robe worn by, what's that? What does Heenan have? Little psychological tactics employed by Bobby Heenan now. Bringing the stretcher into the ring. He and Orndorff having a little conversation. Now they're chanting Weasel.
And he doesn't like that a bit. That really aggravates Heenan. He does not like to be called the Weasel.
Bobby the Brain with a stretcher in hand. Down on the outside is now Paul Orndorff circles around, locks up with Jim Young. Two great athletes in there. Young maneuvering around to the backside. Nice maneuver. Paul Orndorff with a reversal. Take down by Jim. Nice maneuver. Trying to get behind him and not quite. Orndorff is quick.
He's very quick. Young tried to drop toe hold him, but he didn't hook him right. And Orndorff just stood right up from it. Right now, I think if people are working Orndorff's mind a little bit by calling him Paul, he doesn't like that.
Young, shoulder, no. Trying to go for the shoulder block, but knee struck a little earlier than the shoulder was about to hit. And Paul Orndorff takes over as Jim Young. Orndorff now, yes and does, shoot Jim Young high in the air. Drops him down in the midsection, and then right back up with another suplex and drops him on the canvas. That was quite a maneuver.
Yeah, that's our first two. He took him out for a suplex. I was wondering what he was going to do, but he dropped right in the midsection, right in that center rope, which really had the wind out of Jim Young. And then he just took him from the bonds right up again and took him on a regular suplex backwards.
Well, Orndorff whipping Jim. Oh, head first. He went out. Orndorff throwing Jim Young. Amazing, this man is moving. Orndorff really gave him a throw through the rope. Orndorff out now. Paul Orndorff. Young was trying to get back in. Orndorff scoops him up. Unbelievable. What a slam on the concrete floor. Bobby the Brain Heenan and Mr. Wonderful. Oh, I can't believe Jim Young's back in the ring, much less on his feet. Off the rope now. Oh, knee punching up Jim Young. And there's that arrogance. There it is, exuding from every pore. Paul Orndorff. Jim Young, after a series of, a suplex, and then from there, a whip through the ropes, and then a body slam. Jim Young catches Orndorff off guard. Series of blows, and uh-oh. Just when Jim Young was about ready to assert himself, look at this. Orndorff with a suplex. Again. Heenan. Appreciating the tactics and the skills of Paul Orndorff. Ooh. Referee should start thinking about ending this one right now, I think.
Well, he knows he's got this manager. Adonis is a serious problem. It's a matter of time. Right now, he's just been very arrogant, and now we're going to see probably. No, I thought we were going to see the pile driver. Instead, what's he going to do? A suplex where?
Oh, no. Again, a most unusual maneuver. What did he say? Now?
Now, I think he meant now, meaning I think he's going to give the pile driver now.
Look at this. Jim Young is out of it. He's going to be more out of it after that. Orndorff covers Young. I can't believe Heenan is throwing in the stretcher. They actually had intentions of using the stretcher when they brought it up. It was not psychological ploy.
Oh, indeed. He wanted to hurt him and use... Whoops, here's the announcer.
Here is your winner, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
This athlete, Paul Orndorff, and Mr. Heenan, look at the smile on his face. I can't believe that he actually brought the stretcher in, and now the stretcher, unfortunately, will be used. Oh, wait a minute. Let's get Mr. Orndorff out of there.
From Miami, Florida, weighing 240 pounds, Jim Young. His opponent from Nashville, Tennessee, weighing 267 pounds, Dr. D, David Schultz.
Dr. D, David Schultz, one of the most temperamental individuals you'll ever meet. Actually, you really don't want to meet this kind of a man. And I don't think Jim Young does either. Very leery to shake hands with Dr. D, David Schultz, and why not? Schultz is, I don't know what you can really say about Schultz except his extraordinary wrestling skills. But other than that, I mean, he is sour grapes all the time. Never has a good word to say about anything or anyone.
Just a mean individual, just seems miserable at all times. And I really don't understand a guy like this as to how, what kind of a life he has, really, because he just seems extremely miserable and unhappy all the time. This Jim Young is a pretty big fella. He looks in pretty good shape. It'd be interesting what kind of competition he can provide for Dr. Schultz. But one mistake he made a while ago, he had Schultz against the ropes and he broke off. With Schultz, you can't do that. You take everything that you can. You got him against there, you take advantage, because Schultz is merciless. He's as cruel. So he's not going to do the same for you. So you got to take advantage.
Another reminder that World Wrestling Federation Action organization-sponsored WWF action comes to the Keith High School Gym in New Bedford this Wednesday night. On the card, you'll see the Moondogs, Rex and Spot, Polish Power, Ivan Putski, and the reigning Intercontinental Champion, Greg the Hammer Valentine, in New Bedford at the Keith High School this Wednesday night.
It's a good size to him, and he's certainly got a lot of experience, but at times he does seem overconfident and cocky, and... when such an occasion happens, it's perhaps like today here, tonight, with this Jim Young. That's where a guy like Jim Young's going to take advantage. Get him against the ropes, drive a knee right to the solar plexus, knock that wind out of him, and that may just be the thing that, might do the thing.
Well, here, Schultz using his sizable weight advantage and just sort of riding, more or less, leaning into Jim Young.
Well, he's got that big headlock on him, and he's also pushing his own weight against Young's chest, which sometimes, takes the breath out of you. Now he's up, of course, but whoa, did you see that shot? Now he's come followed by a big body slam.
Dr. D, David Schultz in control, and David Schultz now on the second rope, spins in midair and drives the elbow. David Schultz covering Jim Young, a sloppy cover, nonetheless, it's enough. Dr. D, David Schultz. And that D can stand for a lot of things, I would think, as we will now get the official decision.
Here is your winner, Dr. D, David Schultz.
That is one mean hombre right there, Dr. D. David Schultz, a man who has no friends at all that I know of and professes not to need any.
But very
peering
tough.
Out, yes, peering out before this capacity crowd and not seeing, let's maybe saying something.
Everybody wants to fight me. Everybody's running. Everybody's running. Somebody come to the
Introducing first the manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan.
And the $15,000 is still up for any man that can slam John Studd in the ring.
Mr. Heenan represents first from Portland, Oregon, at 267 pounds, recognized as one of the strongest men in the world today, Ken Patera. His partner from Los Angeles, California, weighing 368 pounds, Big John Studd.
That's the giant Studd, and that's right, punks, 15 grand if you slam me.
Their opponents from Miami, Florida, weighing 240 pounds, Jim Young. And from Kensington, New York, at 235 pounds, Paul Roma.
Paul Roma and Jim Young, what a task before them as they take on two monsters of the squared circle, Ken Patera and Big John Studd. $15,000 still outstanding for any one individual who can slam Big John Studd in the ring. And Roma going right after it, and Studd just shoves him away.
He didn't even budge him. I'm a little surprised because this Paul Roma is a pretty good lifter and he looks very, very good. I thought at least he might get him
off. Jim Young going for it. Bruno gets him on his toes and then that's all.
Yeah. Stop that, no trouble though. Look at this.
Ooh. Big John tagging in. Ken Patera lunging, making a tag to Paul Roma. It was Jim Young moments ago. And Patera attacking Roma before he got in the ring. Takes him over and down to the canvas. Young kicking out quickly. Wide open, and Big John takes full advantage. Down in the middle of the back now. Ooh, wow, what a hammer. At 367 pounds, Big John Studd can lay him down. Shoulder block. Roma down like a ton of bricks.
You say a hammer, that's a sledgehammer coming and pull Roma's back, because Studd really knows how to put that weight behind him when he comes down with those.
Studd recently setting the unofficial bench press record at right around 700 pounds. Incredible, incredible lift.
That is so, so incredible. I can't believe it. It's so incredible.
Ken Patera with a forearm on Roma. Oh, Young better watch himself, and it was indeed. But now, Patera have to fight his way out of the corner.
But look at the mistake. Young was outside. He could have got Patera from the back around the head and give Roma a chance to do something. Instead, he came in too. And oh, look at this.
Patera and Jim Young in trouble. Look at Patera. Boy, is he ever looking good.
When Patera gives somebody a vertical suplex, I've never seen anybody lift somebody up with such ease like Patera does. Like if it were a feather.
Big John Studd with Jim Young across the back. I suspect that will spell defeat for the team of Young and Roma. It does indeed. Bobby the Brain Heenan delighted with this latest victory. Oh no, look at double team everything. Patera and Big John Studd will absolutely not stop.
Your winners, Ken Patera, Big John Studd. Ladies and gentlemen, about to enter the ring, first of all, here is the manager, Luscious John Valiant. And he represents, from parts unknown, weighing 273 pounds, Brutus Beefcake. His opponent, from Miami, Florida, weighing 254 pounds, Jim Young.
Jim Young, a fine, outstanding athlete, to lock up with another outstanding athlete. Yes, call him what you will, fruitcake, flatcake, whatever. Brutus is quite a talent. Bruno, would you concur with that?
I'll be the first one to tell you I don't like Beefcake. I don't like it because of his tactic, his arrogance, and so forth. But you cannot take away from him his talent, because he's a big man. He's in very good shape. He's got a manager that's always driving him and driving him hard. He trains extremely hard, and he is extremely successful as an individual. And in tag teams, he and his manager, Johnny Valiant, are extremely successful. So there's no question about it. Love him or hate the man, but he is one of the toughest competitors in that ring today.
I believe the announcer listed him as 273 pounds. To me, he's dropped quite a bit of weight. He appears maybe 15 pounds lighter.
Well, I inquired about that from one of the deputy commissioners. They tell me when he got on the scale, he was 273.
Oh, he is really put together.
Well, that's because, you know, there's no excess.
Oh, look at that! Young with a takedown, nice headlock, and now back in the standing position.
And I think that upsets Beefcake. He doesn't like to be outdone.
Nicely done, and over he goes again. And Brutus, nice maneuver on the part of Brutus. Count of two. Jim Young still hanging on to the side headlock.
For our fans in Reading, Massachusetts, it's just 1 week away. In 1 week's time, on Saturday, May 4th, an all-star card is coming to the Reading High School gym. Great stars such as, well, the British Bulldogs, the Dynamite Kid and Davey Boy Smith, tremendous competitors, and the man who seems to be most controversial these days, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. These stars and more at the Reading High School gym in Reading, Mass, in a week's time on Saturday, May 4th.
Now that lock, and so far he can't seem to be getting out of it. Although here he is again. Let's see what he's going to do with that. Whoa!
Yeah. That's one way to get rid of a side headlock.
Indeed it is.
Brutus Beefcake can do damage, there's no doubt of that, and certainly an individual that will attest to that is Hillbilly Jim, who is still, unfortunately, convalescing. Hillbilly Jim's knee is almost destroyed forever. And of course, we have been following the progress of the recuperation of Hillbilly Jim.
You know what's really disgusting is Brutus Beefcake and Valiant have been bragging all over the country how they did Big Jim in, you know, and that is so rotten.
Fans beginning to chant, fruit kick, look at the elbow right in the butt of the jaw.
That gets him upset. He gets very angry when people shout that.
Oh, man, look at that. Nice maneuver on the part of Brutus Beefcake. As Jim Young was trying to fly over, Brutus Beefcake simply ducked. Nice maneuver. Off the rope. Oh, my. The knee right in, it appeared the nose, right in the face. Brutus Beefcake may have knocked out Jim Young. And a three count. Referee Brutus Beefcake in the ring with luscious Johnny Valiant. Beefcake strutting a bit, but certainly Jim Young had his moments in the match. We'll get the official decision.
Here is your winner, Brutus Beefcake. In the ring at this time, from Tampa, Florida, weighing 257 pounds, Jim Young. Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, presented by Bobby the Brain Heenan, the Missing Link.
Oh, my. If you've never seen this man before, do not adjust your television set. Well, this is truly the way this man looks. And he lives up to his moniker, the Missing Link. It's a good question.
I guess you might say his head is his most dangerous weapon.
Yes, he uses his head as a weapon. Look at that.
Yeah, but he usually gets the back of his hair to drive.
There he goes again.
advice now from Bobby the Brain here.
Ooh,
my. This man is just he torpedoes himself. Look
at that. Grabs the back of his hair to drive, puts more drive, more force in his headbutts.
Ooh. Oh. He'll headbutt you anywhere.
Yeah.
This time he got Jim Young in the shoulder.
As a matter of fact,
we have seen the Link set up a chair. He'll grab a chair from the outside arena and put it in the middle of the ring, climb up to the top rope, take the back of his head, and ram his head into the chair.
I've also seen him use his head so much to where he actually start bleeding.
Yes, he's busted himself open.
Yeah, but it doesn't seem to faze him at all. He doesn't get hurt by it.
Oh, wow. Ah.
Very unusual. Yeah, I guess he's got to be the most unusual man we've ever seen in that ring.
Ooh, Jim Young slammed down the canvas.
It's Jim Young, you know, he's no slouch. He's a fine-looking athlete, 255 pounds. Ooh. Oh, brother.
This missing link is too much. Look at him. Continuing to ram his head into his opponent. You get the impression sometimes that Bobby the Brain Heenan has difficulty in managing, or at least controlling,
yes,
the missing link.
I think so.
The winner of this bout, the missing link.
The Link, a well-conditioned individual. When you take a look at this man's physique, he's really put together.
Well, you know, that's right. You have to. We look at his face, it's so grotesque looking, but his body is really a well-trained, well-conditioned body. You can just looking at this guy, you know that. Whatever training he does an awful lot of it because he's in magnificent shape. But that face, wow.
The face is enough to startle an opponent. Oh, wait a minute. I think he's looking at the ring announcer. I'm not too sure.
I think he's scared of seeing him. I think Eden doesn't feel that sure, that confident about this guy.
This is a one-fall contest. Introducing first to my left, the manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan. And he represents from Los Angeles, California, weighing 367 pounds, Big John Studd.
Holding in his hand $15,000. And a bag of hair off the head of the dummy, Andre, the so-called giant.
His opponent from Tampa, Florida, weighing 254 pounds, Jim Young.
Jim Young.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have been told by Big John Studd to Mr. Young, if you can slam Big John Studd, the $15,000 prize is yours.
Oh my goodness, would these fans be ecstatic if Jim Young slammed Big John Studd? Here he goes, trying to get the big man up. And Studd sort of sits out on, I guess, the $15,000 is safe again. Drop kick. Backs Big John up. Goes for it again. And draws. Look at that. Ooh, form across the back. Big John Studd.
Well, that was smart what Young did. He couldn't slam him. So he drop kicked, trying to get him off balance. And then tried to slam him. Cut him off about a foot, but that was it.
Covered by Big John. Yank of the hair. As we said earlier on, Andre scheduled to join us, but in the frame of mind that the giant was in, no one would sign a contract to face Andre one-on-one. And Big John, rather sporingly, I might say, very much looked. Wait a minute. Andre takes his jacket off. Andre coming into the ring. Andre through the rope. Big John Studd hammering on Andre. Studd hammering.
Two giants in there. Hammering, going back and forth. Ciampa, oh no, good shot. Andre reaching. Bobby Heenan keeping Big John Studd at bay. They were going at it like two animals, two giant-sized animals.
Look at this,
here
coming
he
back.
He's coming back.
Heenan's pushing away. Heenan says no. Oh.
That's an angry giant. Justifiably so. A very angry giant.
But look at Stott. Stott wants to go in. It's Heenan. Heenan is pushing him back. Say, no, no. Get back to the dressing room. But Andre, look at him. He's waiting. He wants him to come back.
The $15,000 and the bag of hair in the hand of Big John Studd as Andre wants John Studd to step back into the ring. Boy, is he angry.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this bout, as a result of a disqualification for outside interference, Big John Studd.
Big John gets the Duke. But obviously, it would appear as though Andre set up Big John Studd just so he could get his hands on him here.
And he's not interested in the $15,000 either, no, Andre. He just wants John Studd, and he wants to just give the licking of his life.
Listen to these fans. Andre, Andre, Andre.
In this event, this tag team, one fall with a 10-minute time. They're introducing first, from Tampa, Florida, 240 pounds, here's Jim Young. Jim Young. And here's his partner from Hollywood, California, Hollywood Brown. Hollywood Brown. Ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, two of wrestling's most dynamic competitors, at a combined weight of 495 pounds, here are Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff and his partner, Rowdy Roddy Piper. In their corner, the ace, Cowboy Bob Orton. Here are Piper, Orndorff, and accompanied by Bob Orton.
Hot Rod, along with his partner, Mr. Wonderful, should be heading for the ring. Instead, they're heading in my direction.
Very seldom large human being does Mr. Wonderful and myself ever wrestle on television. And people might wonder why. And instead of one picture tells a thousand words, doesn't it?
Well, we'll just have to remain in scene. Ace, why don't you take these two individuals up to the ring and get this match underway before you count it out.
I'm going to enjoy watching this so much. Pain is so much fun when you're on.
Thank
the
you
end.
Very much. Well, these two really exuding with confidence, all three of them. I'm sure they feel that they're invincible. Hollywood Brown going to try to give them some competition along with Jim Young. Good-looking athlete. Bell's underway. Mr. Wonderful starting this matchup. Wow, does he look impressive? Look at the body on him. And really going to work, pounding down. Mr. Orndorff not wasting any time. Wow, clothesline. Catches Young coming off the ropes. And the youngster's in trouble right off the bat. Look out. Pile driver. Can't believe it. Wow, he jammed his neck down into the canvas. This match should be over for all intents and purposes. Going to give him another pile driver? Come on, give me a break. Referee, look out. Wow, look at the added leverage as Piper came off the turnbuckle. This young individual probably could have his career terminated right here.
Get out of the ring, man.
He is out completely. Referee, give me a break.
Come on, brother.
Hollywood Brown in there. In the meantime, Jim Young is down on the floor. He is out of it. Hollywood Brown now being pummeled heavy by Piper. Wow.
Get up!
Piper screaming at Hollywood Brown to get up. So he could knock him down again. Brown trying to mount some offense here, but doesn't look good. In the meantime, from my vantage point, I can still see Jim Young down on a concrete floor. He hasn't moved yet. This youngster might just have had his career terminated this week on Georgia Championship Wrestling by these two. Orndorff with a big elbow off the top turnbuckle. Referee distracted now by Hot Rod. And Hollywood Brown, literally in the land of no return, is a backbreaker applied by Mr. Wonderful. These two individuals are devastating once again. Motionless on the concrete arena floor is Jim Young. Hot Rod shouting something about why they don't wrestle on television. Look at this, Orndorff. What a fantastic maneuver, as he had a cradle position on Hollywood Brown and just threw him over into a suplex. But look out, Hollywood Brown going for the ride again outside, and Piper right out there. Dangerous place to be on this concrete floor. Oh, Piper with a big right hand drops the youngster. Just leveled him. Piper just relentless. And throws Hollywood Brown back inside the ring. Talk about your domination. Certainly these two could have used a little stiffer competition here. As once again, I must reiterate, Jim Young is still motionless on the concrete floor. And Mr. Wonderful. Look at a little conference here. There wasn't any tag there, I don't think. Look at Piper. Well, you can't sell these individuals short. They certainly possess the artillery to do a number on anybody that desires to step into the ring with them. You better have it all together when you decide to do that, because this is a sensational team and a devastating team, and a team that will show no mercy. They won't give you any quarter. They don't ask for any. They won't give you any. And there's Piper now taunting. I don't know who he's taunting, because from our vantage point, Jim Young is unconscious. He's down on the floor. Could get the doctor over there to have a look at him. Sleeper hole now being applied by Piper. And he's out. Young has just been carried out. He's completely gone. Look, what's this? What's Piper got? Some kind of a mask or something? No. Oh, look at that. That is ridiculous. That is disgusting. Not only did they beat and humble these two individuals, now they're humiliating them. Look at this. Unbelievable. Hollywood Brown doesn't know where he is, doesn't know what's happening, has no idea what's going on. Now he realizes something's been placed on his head. Oh, that's disgusting. And from behind. Oh, we should have a reversal here in the decision. It's Cowboy Orton using that cast from the backside. Just really rocked and knocked cold Hollywood Brown. Look at putting this hairpiece once again on the unconscious form of Hollywood Brown, and Orndorff slapping this individual. Somebody should come out here and get these guys out of the ring. Come on, referee, give me a break. Orndorff saying, who does this remind you of? Who does this look like? Give me a break, referee. Get these guys out of the ring.
Jesse, have you ever seen him? I'll tell you, I have to admit, I was very impressed watching the magnificent one on the Big Sur with the surfboard. Boy, I'll tell you, he's a champion out on those waves, I'll tell you that.
Well, I'll tell you, the magnificent Muraco is a prime, tremendous athlete, whether it be surfing, whether it be professional wrestling, whatever. Muraco is magnificent.
The bell, the match underway.
You see that? The magnificent one. He says that he's asking me if I want a pile driver tonight, and I gave him the nod. I gave his manager, Mr. Fuji, the nod, saying, yeah, I'd like to see the pile driver,
Jack. Dedication time again?
Might be.
Yes. Got him with the elbow. Big Jim Young, young man from Florida. Look at that. Reverse neck breaker in there by the magnificent Muraco. Already now he's dedicating his pile driver to you?
Well, you know, I'm a popular person with a lot of people, Jack Reynolds. You know, just because you don't have a lot of friends don't mean the rest of us
don't. I don't have a lot of friends. My friends don't dedicate pile drivers in the ring. They do their business.
so does the magnificent Muraco. Watch him do his business right here on Jim Young. Out to the floor. Ouch.
Big Jim Young out of the ring right now. Look at Fuji. Oh, and he got him. Fuji with that cane. Oh, he got him good.
Did he get him?
Oh, did he nail him?
I couldn't really tell.
Look at,
there
look at him. Oh, he loves
whatever
it.
He did, he's very pleased with himself.
Yeah. Ohio, Ohio, yes. Here's the magnificent one. Big power slam. Woo. One? No, he's not. No.
I heard
no
Mr.
Way.
Fuji yeah. say, get pull him up, pull right. him up, pull
I
him
heard
up.
Him. Big knee lift. Oh, what a pasting Jim Young is taking.
And Jim Young is a fine athlete, but the magnificent Muraco is not even giving him room to breathe. Drops a big elbow in there on him, Jack.
Grabbing the hair, pulling at the hair of Jim Young. There's another elbow. Jim Young goes down with that blow. What a crushing, damaging man this Muraco is.
He just took his boot top and scraped it right across Young's face. It's time.
Uh-oh.
He said it's time.
I
Jesse.
Heard him. Look at this. Look at this.
Whoa. Whoa.
Just for Jesse the Body.
For Jesse the Body. You heard him. You heard him. Listen to that. With our World Wrestling Federation cameras and microphones right on top of all the action as he dedicated his pile driver to my co-host, who is smiling from ear to ear right now.
That was for Jesse the Body.
Oh, he loves it.
The winner of the match, the magnificent Muraco.
Oh, boy. I'll tell you what friendship can do, I'll tell you.
You hear the applause?
Yeah, I see it.
There's the applause right there, Jack Reynolds.
Yeah, I know.
Earlier on, as he was walking to the ring, he brought with him, Bruno, what appeared to be a branding iron. Take a look at that kisser, would you?
He brought a branding iron, yes. He's got to put his mark on his opponent after he whips him. And I noticed when he gave his hat to the second that he was watching what he was going to do with it. But the fella gently grabbed it with his hand and held it there, remembering what happened some weeks ago to that gentleman, Mel.
Yes, Mel Phillips was sent to the hospital thanks to Terry Funk. Chopped to the throat area. Terry Funk now with Jim Young. Takes him through the ropes and all the way outside. Coming outside with him now. Terry Funk looking down on Jim Young. Ooh, the kick to the... Oh, my goodness. Kick him right in the back of the head. Wow. What a chin.
Get up.
And every time Young goes down, he keeps hitting that steel fence there.
Now that is certainly every bit of justification needed for an official to disqualify a man.
Well,
this official has been criticized on many an occasion for not disqualifying someone. Well, perhaps he should, allowing maybe too much chicanery to go on in the ring. Ooh, wow. Vintage Terry Funk.
That's how they cure maybe the likes of Terry Funk. When he keeps doing that to an opponent outside the ring, keeps refuse to let him in, disqualify him a few times. Maybe then it would be a bit of a cure. But he is a vicious, vicious man. This Funk. I've known a lot of wrestlers to come out of Texas, but I'm not sure that I've ever seen anybody quite as mean and vicious as Terry Funk. Here comes the suplex.
Looks like it. Yes, indeed. Has him up. Round. Yes. Down to the canvas. Terry Funk. What's he going to do now? Alter rope and drops the elbow on Jim Young. That could very well be it. No. Young kicking out, showing some spirit in there.
Young's a pretty tough customer. He doesn't appear to be today because of Funk. And Funk's been so mean and vicious. But Young is a good-looking athlete. Ooh. He's a tough athlete.
Telegraphed the attempt of back body drop, brother. Jim Young did.
You can't make mistakes with Funk. He's been there too long, and the slightest mistake, he'll take advantage of it. See what happens now. Ooh.
Elbow to the back of the head, and Funk continuing to hammer with the elbows. But Jim Young retaliating. And sends Funk flying across the ring. Jim Young with a drop kick. Terry Funk down the canvas again. Jim Young hesitating a little bit now, moving in. Gets him up. Yes. Slams it to the canvas. Young with an elbow that missed by a mile.
Missed by Amala's right. A bad move. Uh-oh. We saw him do this once before. Watch this. Now he'll drop right on that top rope. Boom. Right across the neck. I'll tell you. It could decapitate a person.
Terry Funk slapping a sleeper hold on Jim Young. And thus far, Terry Funk has been very, very successful with the sleeper hold.
Well, he uses the sleeper hold and he does also the spinning toe hold. But right now, Jim Young is down. Look at this. He's passed out. This is it.
Come on, referee. What's he going to wait, forever?
Yeah.
It's over. Now, Funk going outside the ring, and he just may bring in that branding iron he brought with him. Yes, he is. That's exactly what he's doing.
Oh, you kidding me?
He's bringing in the branding iron. And he is going to brand him. I think he is exactly what he's going to do. Look at that.
Yeah, look at that.
He is branding Jim Young. He's been branded.
Well, I'll be.
I guess maybe we've seen it all now. Terry Funk branding Jim Young.
Introducing first to my right, from Florida at 255 pounds, Jimmy Young. His opponent from Atlantic City, New Jersey, 230 pounds, Bobby Leon. Their opponent from Las Vegas, Nevada, at 240 pounds, Barry O. His partner from parts unknown, at 296 pounds, Moondog Spot.
Moondog Spot and Barry O to face Jim Young and Bobby Rion. Well, I'll tell you, Bobby Rion is a newcomer, I believe, but Jim Young is a big fella and he's been around a good while, but here is facing Moondog Spot and Barry O. We'll see what happens here with Moondog Spot and Big Jim Young.
Moondog Spot, by the way, has been doing very well for himself as of late in individual competition.
See, he has. He's a tough customer. He's 280, 290 pounds, and he's tough.
Ladies and gentlemen, the eyes of the wrestling world, and in New England per se, are going to focus on Sullivan Stadium in Foxborough, Massachusetts, on Monday night, July 8th, for an unbelievable Super Summer Wrestling Extravaganza. You'll hear more about this next week. Tickets are on sale at all Ticketron locations. Topping the bill will be a one-night elimination tournament to determine who is the king of the ring. This is going to happen at Sullivan Stadium, Foxborough, Massachusetts, Monday, July 8th at 7:30 p.m.
Boy, quick cover and almost a three count.
Almost.
Frequent tags thus far on the part of Barry O and Moondog Spot.
Quick tags, and they got Jim Young in trouble. They're keeping him close to their corner, and although right now he's, might have been close enough to tag Bobby Rion, but he didn't.
Spot holding up, driving the knee into the spine. Oh, my goodness.
Boy, I'll tell you, that hurts. When you get slammed on a knee with the small of your back, that really, really hurts.
Barry O from the second rope to get a little more leverage coming down. But Jim Young is in a lot of trouble. Barry O coming off the rope and lowers the boom. Oh, between the legs, there we go, and Leon comes in. Nice lunge. Bob Leon. Nah, he's not doing much there at all, Bruno.
No, he came in, but he was trying to throw some shots in the midsection of Barry O, but there was nothing behind him. We're not going to do any damage that way. I was surprised. Well, we can't see. He looks like he's showing some rights.
Bob Leon taken right over, however, by Moondog Spot. Tag was made, I believe, behind the back as Leon now hurled to the ropes. Ooh, look at this. Ooh, my, dumped him right on his head. Could very well have broken his neck. Ooh, my. Cover by Barry O. And a three count. I think maybe they could have had the count just by putting a finger on this guy, Leon. I'm afraid Leon has suffered a neck injury.
He dumped him right on his head. I mean,
boy, he really did. And getting no sympathy whatsoever from Moondog Spot and Barry O.
The winners of this bout, the team of Barry O and Moondog Spot.
Barry O and Moondog Spot victorious.
In the ring to my right, from Tampa, Florida, weighing 257 pounds, Jim Young. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, from Sarasota, Florida, weighing 235 pounds, the man who is in demand by wrestling managers galore, the number one free agent, Randy Macho Man Savage.
The Macho Man, Randy Savage, and indeed, he is without a doubt the World Wrestling Federation's number one free agent. I think it's to show his gratitude, he has invited all of the managers who were bidding for his services. He's invited them out to the ring just to show his gratitude for their support.
Yeah, but
even though they themselves, so we have been told, know that they're not among the one individual whom he has chosen.
Fine, but whoever he's chosen, where are they? I just see the managers that we're familiar with. I don't see anybody different or somebody we don't know. I'll bet she's still going to pick one of the ones that we know. Maybe just to throw us off or something.
Well, it was reported that he is going to announce whom his manager is, and it's not allegedly one of these gentlemen. Maybe he's double-crossing everyone. I just don't know.
I wouldn't be a bit surprised.
Mr. Fuji has really been hard at work. All of them, actually. The ring announcer was right. The number one free agent in the WWF.
Well, what's going to happen? He's going to wrestle now, then announce his manager.
Apparently.
Okay.
Macho Man with a quick arm drag. A very, very impressive athlete. You have to give him that.
Oh, I'll tell you, very unusual.
Oh, my.
What a mistake Young may turn his back on a guy like this.
Well, he was distracted. He had Blassie and Heenan yelling at him, and Johnny Valiant as well.
Well, you don't let nobody distract you. Look at this now.
No,
watch
don't
this.
Don't do that. Macho Man from the top rope. Oh, my. I don't know anyone that does that. Out to the concrete floor, whipping Jim Young back in, Macho Man Randy Savage.
But can you imagine the force coming from that top rope when he comes with his full weight coming down on an opponent with that height? That's devastating. Look at this suplex, how long he's holding him there. Boom. And here he goes.
Oh, wait a minute. Going up to the top rope now after the suplex, the Macho Man Randy Savage. Looking on Freddie Plassey, Bobby the Brain Heenan, and on the top rope, the Macho Man. Boom! Wow! Incredible elbow. And after that elbow lands, and the party is over.
For sure.
The Macho Man, Randy Savage, victorious. Oh, Jim Young now. Oh, come on.
I throws him outside the ring.
Here is your winner, Randy Macho Man. Savage.
Apparently, we're going to hear from him.
Oh, yeah, everybody concentrate right now. This is the big day. This is the big day. And I want to thank all these managers right now for your consideration. Mr. Fuji, devious ways that you put in my mind will come to use. Bobby the Brain Heenan, what you've taught me. Oh, yeah, I'm going to use forever. Johnny Valiant, oh, yeah, the training will be in effect for the rest of my life. The diamonds that Freddie Blassie has flashed in front of my eyes really makes me smile. And it's been fantastic for your consideration. And Jimmy Hart, the complete opposite, just freaked me out. But now, look. The mystery be over. Macho madness at this peak right now. And we gotta know who the manager is gonna be of the future WWF World Heavyweight Champion.
Oh,
right behind that door right now is the Macho Man's new manager. Everybody get ready. A big, big moment. And here she comes.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my goodness.
Is this a movie star? Who is this?
My goodness. Take a look. What a surprise. I can't believe. Look at this. What a beautiful woman. My goodness. She is absolutely gorgeous. Oh, my. Look at the smile. That is a gorgeous, gorgeous lady. My goodness, that is Jimmy Hart holding the ropes. The Macho Man said no. I can't believe that. Take a look at this. The Macho Man introducing the managers to his current manager. Oh, my. I don't know what in the world. We're going to have to find out a lot more about this lady. She must be something to have, in some fashion, cajoled the Macho Man into accepting her as a manager. Oh, my. Ooh.
She's beautiful, but for me, it's still a mystery. Who is she?
I don't know. I don't have the slightest idea.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring to my right, from Tampa, Florida, weighing 258 pounds, Jim Young. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent is now under the new management of the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. And about to enter the ring to the music of Jimmy Hart's new record from New York City, weighing 252 pounds, Adrian Adonis.
What is that sound?
I called my chick on the phone last night. Her mother said she was gone for the night. She had to take this to a rock and roll show to see who
too sure how well the fans received that. I thought it was done quite well, Colonel, but keep your heart out, Rick Springfield. Is that what he was saying?
That's what it sounded like. But did you see how he had that thing chained to his wrist? I'm curious. Do you know what is in that bag?
I haven't the foggiest idea. Jimmy Hart now managing Adrian Adonis. You can bet Mr. Hart is really excited about this latest turn of events.
Well, this Adrian Adonis is quite a competitor in that ring. I know that most fans don't care for him much, but I'll tell you, he's quite a wrestler. In that ring, he displays a lot of great wrestling maneuvers. Look at this.
Yes,
a lot of quickness.
Right away.
And of course, he's a very vicious individual, so that when you take the combination of all his wrestling skills, plus all that conniver in that ring, is quite tough.
Jim Young in there with Adrian Adonis. Mr. Young himself, quite a wrestling talent, really coming into his own. But I wonder why. Well, wait a minute. to join us now, Bobby, the Brain Heenan, and I'll tell you what, you've got a lot of guts considering what you did last week to even show your kisser around this arena.
Maybe you don't understand something, Mr. McMahon. I am Bobby the Brain Heenan. I do exactly what I want to do. And I'd like to clear a few things up for you and the wrestling fans out there.
All right, well, could you possibly clear up why? What possessed you to do what you did last week? This man, Hillbilly Jim, has bruised ribs. You could have re-injured his knee. He could have been out of wrestling forever. That is not, however, I'm happy to say, the case.
No, but it could be the case, and it will be the case if anybody else ever tries to embarrass me again. I won that Manager of the Year award fair and square. I commandeered more votes than anybody in the history of professional wrestling. That's my trophy, my award.
Wait a minute. You and some of your cohorts did, yes. But it was you and Fuji, Blassie, and a whole host of others. It wasn't just you.
That's because I'm the Brain. I engineered this. I'm not going to be made a fool of by some ignorant hillbilly and some big slob with rubber bands on his face. As far as I'm concerned, I'm Manager of the Year. I'd like to tell you another thing I did. When I made the big deal with Adrian Adonis, Bundy, the Missing Link, and Jimmy Hart, what I received for Adrian Adonis and the Missing Link is unheard of in professional wrestling. I made more money out of that deal than I've ever made in my life. Adrian's a very, very skilled athlete, a very, very skilled wrestler.
All right, wait a minute. Let's get the official decision, and then we'll have a further word with you.
Here is your winner, Adrian Adonis.
All right. There were rumors you couldn't control Adonis.
I can control anybody at any time. Adonis is a little bit hard to control sometimes.
This is a handicap match. Two against one, scheduled for one fall. First of all, to my left, here is the manager, Beverly Hills, California, Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Manager of the Year.
His protege from Atlantic City, New Jersey, weighing 458 pounds, King Kong Bundy. He will face the team of, from Florida, weighing 260 pounds, Jim Young. And from Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, 233 pounds, Gary Starr.
Now here, a little strategy on the part of Gary Starr, and Jim Young certainly would pay off against this mammoth, King Kong Bundy. Under normal circumstances, a handicap match would have one opponent on the outside in tag team style at all times.
Okay, but being that they're both allowed in the ring at the same time, right there is a stupid mistake. They both wrist lock Bundy from a standing position. Now here's Bundy, 458 pounds, a mammoth of a man, powerful, so forth, and you don't do that. Now over here, look at this. What they should be doing, both of them, they should be both going very, very low, not even at the thighs, at the ankle area. So that will take the balance away from Bundy, and hopefully, I say hopefully, they can get him down on the mat. And then once you get him on the mat, maybe there's a little bit of a chance that they can do something. But what they're doing is totally useless. Look at this. It's like trying to lock a Sherman Tang down. You can't do it.
Double shoulder blocks and...
I mean, this is a big, powerful, powerful man. And when I say big, I'm using the word lightly. He's gargantuan size. I mean, the guy's a mammoth. Now, look at this.
Trying to go for a slam of sorts. I've been thinking Bundy just lowering the hammer. Mm. But now, trying to get behind him, that may have Bundy, who, McMitsby. Oh, all they do is back Bundy into Gary Starr. Now, back out now with Jim Young. Uppercut. Bundy is so huge.
Oh, he's colossal. And he can move for his size, you know. But you saw a little while ago, Starr leaped up on him. If Starr had hooked him from behind at the ankles, and that was Young who came up with a drop kick, they might have... Oh, look at this. Oh. Look at this on both of them. Oh, brother.
Bundy drops an elbow. One, two. You can count to 100 if you want, Russ. Well, at least we get to 5. King Kong Bundy. The man is awesome. Yeah.
the brain behind him, Mr. Heenan, there may not be any stopping King Kong Bundy.
The winner of the handicap match, King Kong Bundy.
King Kong Bundy. I don't think Mr. Bundy needs Weight Watchers. I don't think he's subscribed at any event. His weight way up there. He may, if he continues at this rate, may approach the 500-pound mark if he could carry it. And he indeed is just about as strong as an elephant.